What's up? I want to look at Worried About You. Worried About You is in three sections. Call them A, B, and C. It's important to clarify that I'm not suggesting that once the A section concludes, then the B section happens, and once the B section is over, then the song ends on the C section. So I'll come back to that. The A section of the song is the C to F chord. The song is in the key of C, and the electric piano starts, or the whatever that is, whirly. It starts with a... C to an F, and on the F chord, do add the D to make the F a D minor. You can go from F to D minor and back to C. That's a nice transition chord. He plays it on the electric piano throughout the song, and you could play it on the guitar. You could get by with just going... Sounds nice, and it's in there. So that's the A section. The A section, the verse rides over top of the A section, as does the outro. The B section of the song happens with, to use some of the A section to get to the B section. Signature lick of the song on the guitar. That is a D minor to an F, and then on the F chord, I'm adding the G on the third fret, top E string. You don't have to, but he's singing that note, so I do. If you didn't add that, it would be fine. Another note, I'm playing the D minor like this. I've got an F in the bass. You may be more familiar with that shape if you have the, you potentially have a D in the root. I just put the F in the root. Have it. I'm worried. And let me get a little closer here to show you how you could play the lick. Here's a C. E to F to D to E. So the last note of the lick ends on an F. The lick is initiated in the C chord, but it ends on an F. Here's a C. F. Got it? Good. Now the C section. The C section is introduced from the A section. Again, it's important to understand. It's not the song starts in A, and then has a B section, then has a C section. It varies. The predominant section in the song, and the one given the most time, if the song is, what, 4:24, most of that is spent on the A section, the C to F change. So here is the C section. I'll do this slowly. 'Cause I'm worried, I find out anyway. Sure as hell burns, I'm gonna find that girl someday. 'Cause I'm worried and I just can't seem to find my way. Here's the making you falsetto, Mick. It's freaking wonderful. I'll call those chords out. Cause I'm D minor and I G anyway. Sure as F burns, I'm gonna find that D minor someday. Cause I'm D minor and I'm F, F, and the G, yeah, C. Alright. So there you go. And now let's look at that lick. A great, and I mean great, you hear me? A great soul and R&B guitar player like Keith Richards. We can finesse that lick in a variety of ways. And a listen to the YouTube live versions of Worried About You finds him doing just that. Let's look at three of those ways that can happen. Come up here to the 5th fret. Pad the C note on the G string and the E note on the B string. And then hammer on with this finger from the E to the F, playing the C. Got it? Two notes, a double stop. Now, drop this finger to the C note on the 5th fret G string, this here, index finger, on the D note on the B string, and hammer on from the D to the E with the little finger. Got it? And then conclude with an F. Just these three notes. The F, the A, and the C. Don't play the top string. Don't play the bottom two strings. So that's, here's the lick, right? E to F, D to E, concluding with a C. Here you've got E to F, D to E, concluding with a C. And what I just showed you is, you could play this. Come down here. You've got a E and a G this time. And you're going to hammer on from E to F. The prior example had you starting this lick padding the C and the E, and then hammering the F. I'm going to change one note up. You've got the E and the G now, and hammer on. It's just changing the harmony a little bit. Hammering on the F. Here's the lick. And here you go. F. So that is an E and a G. Hammer on from the E to the F. Now play a D and a G, hammer on from the D to the E, and finish with a three note F chord. There's the F, there's the A, and there's the C. Okay, and the last thing I want to show you is a way to play that sequence, the C section sequence, up the guitar neck, in the 5th, 6th, and 7th frets. And that would be like this. Cause I'm worried, and I find out anyway, sure as Here's a movable chord shape. Take a B minor. Just backtrack a second. Take a B minor. You do know that you can move that up, and it's a C minor, and a C sharp minor, and a D minor. Well, throw out the bottom two strings. Keep top four, and you got a D minor. Now you want a G. You could play 4, 3, 2, and 1, or you could just play the basic triad with the notes B, D, and G, and get a G chord. Then to an F, that's movable, right? From here to here, and now you're required by the song to play an E minor. Down to a D minor and F, 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 F. If you want to add this G, and you finish with a C chord, a three note C chord. Don't play the top string, don't play the bottom two, just the G, the C, and the E. That I just went chromatically or a half step at a time down from the E minor. Worried. And I just can't see the memory. Alright. Now there are, again, innumerable ways. Well, there's probably a finite number of ways you could do it, but that lick. And so concludes this book at Worried About You. Thanks for watching. Have a good one. See ya.